JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February the 3rd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other G10 currencies on Tuesday during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained against the NOK, the Euro, Aussie, GBP and CHF in that order, while it underperformed versus NZD, the Canadian dollar and SEK. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the Kiwi and the Luni, combined with the weakening of the Swiss franc, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the weakening of the Aussie points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the optimism easing somewhat during the Asian session today. Although Japan's Nikkei 225 and South Korea's KO SPI gained 1 and 1.06% respectively, China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng slid 0.46% and 0.50%. EU indices may have added to Monday gains, perhaps after preliminary data showed that the Eurozone economy contracted by less than expected in the fourth quarter of 2020, as large economies Germany and Spain still managed slight expansions. UK's FTSE 100 gained the least among the EU indices, perhaps weighed by report that the UK variant of the coronavirus has developed a new mutation that could reduce the efficacy of the vaccines. In the US, Wall Street was helped by Amazon and Alphabet, which gained ahead of their earnings results. Market participants were also optimistic over the progress of approving a fiscal spending package in the US as Congress and Democrats took steps in passing Biden's $1.9 trillion bill without Republican support. All the above add more credence to our view that the vaccinations, the monetary policy support around the globe, and the large fiscal package in the US are a blend of developments that are likely to keep the broader market sentiment supported. With all that in mind, we stick to our guns that equities are likely to continue drifting north, while safe havens may stay under selling interest. In the currency world, we expect the pairs consisting of a risk-linked currency and a safe haven to perform well. Such pairs are Aussie dollar, Kiwi dollar, Aussie yen and Kiwi yen. Now, speaking about currencies, the Kiwi was the main G10 gainer, coming under strong buying interest overnight after New Zealand's employment data for the fourth quarter beat market consensus. The unemployment rate declined to 4.9% from 5.3%, instead of rising to 5.6% as the forecast suggested, while the employment change showed that the economy added 0.6% quarter-over-quarter jobs after losing 0.8% in the third quarter. The forecast was for another 0.8% quarter-over-quarter loss. Back in November, the RBNZ decided to keep its official cash rate and its large-scale asset purchase program unchanged, with Governor Andrian Orr saying that domestic activity since August has been more resilient than previously assumed. With that in mind and taking into account that inflation stayed unchanged at 1.4% year-over-year in the fourth quarter within the bank's target range of 1-3%, We believe that the better than expected employment report may have diminished the chances for the adoption of negative interest rates by this central bank. This, combined with an improved overall market sentiment, are likely to keep the New Zealand dollar supported. Bearing in mind that the RBA decided to expand its Kiwi purchases yesterday, we see the case for the Kiwi to outperform even its Australian counterpart. In other words, we believe that Aussie Kiwi is likely to continue drifting south. Now, as for today's events, during the European trading, we have Eurozone's preliminary CPIs for January. The headline CPI rate is forecast to have rebounded to 0.5% year over year from minus 0.3%, while the HICP, excluding energy and food, is forecast to have accelerated to 0.7% year over year from 0.4%. Despite the lockdown measures around the Eurozone, at the latest ECB gathering, President Lagarde said that the downside risks to the economic outlook are now less pronounced, making investors skeptical over further easing by the ECB, although the bank repeated once again that it stands ready to adjust all its instruments as appropriate. Thus, improving inflation rates may reduce even further speculation over more easing by the ECB, at least at its upcoming gathering. We also get the final market services and composite PMIs for January from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, with the final prints expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. In the US, we also get the ISM non-manufacturing PMI for January, which is expected to have fallen to 55 from 60.5, as well as the ADP employment report for January, which is forecast to show that the private sector has gained 45,000 jobs after losing 123,000 in December. As for the speakers, we have two on the agenda, and those are St. Louis Fed President James Bullard and Philadelphia Fed President Patrick Harker. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.